This is the video lecture on inventory valuation. Now, in a previous lecture, we talked about merchandising operations and the fact that they have an inventory account, which is an asset. And in that lecture, we talked about the cost of inventory. Well, in this lesson, we're going to learn where that cost comes from. We're going to learn all the different ways to assign value to our inventory. And the first thing that we're going to talk about are different types of inventory systems. In fact, we have two main types. We could have a periodic system or a perpetual system. Now, in a periodic inventory system, that means that the inventory is only occasionally updated. In other words, we would occasionally have an assessment of our inventory and update our records, versus a perpetual inventory system, in which we would be continuously updating our inventory. Now, when you look at these two options, the difference is pretty clear. Perpetual inventory is definitely going to require more work because you're having that constant effort to continuously keep up with it, versus periodic, which is going to be less work because you only occasionally update the inventory system. But the trade-off is, with perpetual, your inventory records are going to be much more timely and much more up-to-date. So that's why it's usually worth it to go that extra step and have that constant effort to maintain the inventory. And most businesses are going to practice a perpetual inventory, and especially given the technology that's available. You know, many stores have, you know, scanners that can scan the items of inventory as they enter the store. They scan the items as the items of inventory leave. So these technological innovations that we have enable us to have very high quality perpetual inventory systems. Now, even with the technology, we still have to have an occasional physical inventory, because even though we're going to scan every item, there's always the possibility of theft. There's always the possibility of errors. So we always do a physical inventory. Typically, that will be done once a year, and then we will use that to see whether or not we were accurate on our actual inventory count. So that's always a good thing to do, at least once a year, and possibly even more. It depends on what the business decides to do. Now, when it comes to inventory, sometimes there is a very unique problem that is associated with it. And this problem has to do with the actual items of inventory themselves. Many times we will have items of inventory that are identical to each other, and those items of inventory are sometimes stored in the exact same location. But the problem is, when we buy our inventory, we do not necessarily pay the same price. We sometimes buy the inventory from different suppliers, and sometimes the prices go up, and sometimes those prices go down. So we could actually have a problem where we have the same exact identical items stored in the same place, but we pay different prices, and we don't necessarily know how much we paid for each item of inventory. So as a result of that problem, we're going to have to overcome that with a method of inventory valuation. Now, according to GAAP, according to our generally accepted accounting principles, we have four possible methods of inventory valuation. And all four of these methods are considered acceptable and approved according to GAAP. Now, the reason we have to learn all four of these is that different companies have different preferences about inventory. So we have to know all four, because you never know what method a particular company is going to use. So the four methods are specific identification, FIFO, LIFO, and weighted average. So to talk about these methods in more detail, the first method is called specific identification. Of all the methods, this one is actually the most accurate. But the downside to this method is that sometimes this is a very difficult method to practice. In order to practice specific identification, you would actually have to store inventory in separate locations and have a way of identifying how much was paid for each individual item. And sometimes that's possible, but then again, other times it would be difficult. So a very good example that is often used for specific identification would be the example of a car dealership. Imagine that you had a business and you were doing the accounting for this business and it's a car dealership. Even if it's a large dealership, they might have, say, 500 cars in inventory. But the thing is, each one of those cars can be separately identified. Every car has a different color, different options, different makes, different models. And even if you had two identical cars, they all have a unique identification number, like a serial number. So you could potentially separately identify each individual item of inventory and actually know specifically when that item is sold, how much was paid for it, and how much it was sold for. But imagine that same example in a grocery store. In a grocery store, you might have 500 items on one little section of one shelf, and they're all identical to each other. So how would you know which item is which? You wouldn't necessarily know that. So it's great if you can practice specific identification. It is certainly the most accurate, but it's not always possible. And if it's not possible, then we would actually have to move on to one of these other methods. The next method is called FIFO, and this stands for First In, First Out. Now, under this method, we're just going to use an assumption. And the assumption is that the first units that were brought in also happened to be the first units that were sold. Now, we don't necessarily know that that's true, but since we have to do something in order to get the inventory, we could actually use that as an assumption. And if I practice that first in, first out, that could be a way of assessing the value of my inventory. I don't necessarily have to do that, however. I could also go with this method, and this is the LIFO method. And this stands for last in, first out. So this is the exact opposite. If I utilize the LIFO method, I'm assuming that the last items that were brought in are the first items that are sold. And again, that may or may not be true, but it is at least an assumption that I could apply to inventory when I'm trying to figure out which ones were sold. And then I have that fourth option, which is called weighted average. And under this method, we actually would calculate a mathematical average to determine the cost. So this can be a good compromise because it's a little bit more accurate than FIFO or LIFO. Now, to actually compare the methods, like we said, specific identification, the most accurate, and if possible, ideally, we would like to use that method, but it may not always be possible. So if we don't know what the items are and where they're located, we might have to go with first in, first out. If we use that method, it would give us the highest possible gross profit. Or many companies choose to use LIFO, last in, first out. This actually gives you the lowest gross profit and as a result, the lowest taxes, which is always a popular option. And then if we wanted to go with a fair compromise, we could always use the weighted average method, and that would be based on a mathematical average. So like I said, companies have an option because all four of these are considered approved methods according to GAAP. And eventually, when we do our demo problem for this lesson, we're going to actually have the practice of going through each of the four methods, so that way you'll be able to see exactly how these are calculated. Now, once I calculate the cost, I then have to take a step further and actually do an exercise called the lower of cost or market. Now, the reason that we have to do this is because over time, our inventory can become obsolete. In fact, the longer we've had the inventory in stock, the less likely it is that it will ever be sold. So from time to time, I want to review my inventory and I want to take a look at cost and market. Now, cost, that represents the actual price that was paid for the inventory. Whereas market, that represents the current price that is selling on the market. I actually want to pick the lower of the two because that would actually be the more conservative thing to do. Think about it. If anything, I would rather underestimate the value of my inventory because that way if I do end up selling it for the full price, that would be a positive adjustment. But if I overestimate the value of my inventory and I don't end up selling it for that price, I would have to make a negative adjustment. So with inventory, the conservative thing to do would always be to go with the lower price. So I could do that by applying the lower of cost or market.